for the polling to start the first phase onwards. What is the desired outcome that you are expecting from this entire Lok Sabha elections? We know that you don't support India Alliance nor the NDA. What is the desired outcome that you expect?
You see, people have a right to vote for whatever political party they want, but I hope and expect that every person who has his name on the voter list will come out and cast their vote. Now, what I want the voter to understand is that they must remember in the last 5 years, we had this COVID wave in our country, two waves, wherein more than nearly 5 to 10 lakh people, or maybe a huge number of people died. And the reason was that this government was not prepared. Mr. Modi was not to be seen for nearly 20 days when the COVID wave, second wave started. This government utterly failed. We have seen visuals of bodies floating on various rivers. We have seen migrant laborers walking in Aurangabad. They died on railway tracks. This government failed to provide oxygen. Then now this led to huge unemployment, price rise. The youth is suffering because of lack of jobs. Communalism has increased, mob lynching has increased, hatred towards minorities have increased. There is a threat to our constitution. There is a threat to the pluralism and diversity of our country. And on each count, this Modi government has failed. They might talk big about making it the third largest economy, but our where do we stand at per capita income? Petrol is more than 100 rupees. So these are all the factors which I hope people will keep in their mind when they go out and vote and cast their vote for any political party they want. And as far as our party is concerned, we hope that they will vote for us in Hyderabad, Aurangabad and Kishanganj Parliament constituency. And in Uttar Pradesh, we are in alliance with Anupriya Patel. We have formed PDM. And also in Maharashtra, we'll be contesting some more Lok Sabha seats. And in Tamil Nadu, I hope and I request the people of Tamil Nadu to please support AIADMK wherever their candidates are contesting.
So it's very interesting that you have, tied up with some of these very local regional parties like OBC party, like Apna Dal and, AIADMK and all these parties. Is there a specific reason that you decided to go and tie up with these particular regional parties?
To be honest with you, last time around, during the last Tamil Nadu elections, there was a talk between our party and the then Chief Minister, who is now heading the ADMK General Secretary, Edappadi Palaniswamy. But we refused. We said that you are in alliance with BJP. We cannot go further. So now they have assured us that they will not be having an alliance with BJP. And in future also, they will be opposing CAA, NPR, NRC. And my expectation is that in coming assembly elections, AIADMK will be the most powerful political party and the popular political party come assembly elections. And even now, I expect them to perform very well in the Lok Sabha elections. As far as Uttar Pradesh is concerned, our alliance with Anupriya Patel will continue for the next Uttar Pradesh Assembly elections. We'll have to keep on working. It's going to be hard work. I understand it's a challenge and a great, huge opportunity for us. And Maharashtra also will be entering into alliance because Maharashtra, you see, in next 6 months, Assembly elections are going to be held. So we'll have to really gear up not only, fight not only the Lok Sabha election, but also to gear up for the coming assembly elections, which will be held sometime in October of 2024.
Sir, you have seen both the manifestos, the Nyay Patra and what the BJP calls the Sankalp
now,
Patra.
I have seen the BJP today's advertisement in various newspapers. Please see, when they talk about giving loans or help to start a business from the government, it says SC, ST and OBC. The BJP is even refusing to mention the word minority. Forget about Muslim. the word minority is mentioned in the constitution of our India, and the BJP has this great hatred for the word M, and they have not mentioned minorities. They say scholarships will be given to marginalized communities. Now, who are those marginalized communities? Which community has the highest dropout rate after Dalits are Muslims? BJP has deliberately ensured that the dropout rate increases more in the Muslim community, and they have restricted the pre-matric scholarship from class 9 onwards. When the empirical data say that the dropout rate starts from class 4, 5th and 6th. So this is what BJP has done in last 10 years in marginalizing the Muslim community, making them invisible. And this is what the people of India are seeing.
Sir, but if you talk about the last India question. Alliance, you know, there's been speculation that, you know, MIM could ally with Congress. But you have clarified that that isn't the case.
Yes, I have given my clarification.
But is there a specific reason, you know, even if Congress extends its hand, you don't want to reach out?
But see, there is, neither they have extended, neither we are into alliance. Wherever we are in alliance, Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu have mentioned it to you. In Maharashtra, we have taken a very conscious decision of supporting in Akola, Mr. Prakash Ambedkar, and in Amravati, Mr. Anand Ambedkar. And we feel that they are part of Baba Saheb Ambedkar's family, and we owe a great debt of gratitude to them, that they belong to the progeny of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. And we want Dalit voice and the Vanchit voice to be heard in the biggest panchayat of our country. This is what we have done, and I have clarified again that we have no, we have no alliance with any other political party.
Sir, idhar jaakri sawal sir.
Last.
Idhar Telangana bare mein, aap pehli baar chunav mein aap BRS ko support kiya hai, lekin aap sirf Hyderabad mein contest kar rahe hai, to baaki sab seats ko aap specifically BJP harane ka aap kuch koshish kar rahe hai kya?
तो खुला बोला ना मैं, हैदराबाद में भी हराना है, तेलंगाना के 16 पार्लियामेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में बीजेपी को हराने का है, और हमने ये खुलकर कहा इस बात को, तो इसमें कोई छुपाने का नहीं है।